Hello there, fellow crafters. My name is George and this is the Springtime G, and today we're gonna make this guy a tiny octopus from clay, of course. So it has been a long while since I have done a last simple animal creature on my channel, not like a subnautica leviathan or military model or some kind of a comic book character, and I wanted to continue it by making octopus, which is one of my favorite animals and also my favorite thing to sculpt, because it is more or less easy to like resemble a real thing even in a short period of time, and it can be a nice stepping stone for you to start sculpting. So as you're seeing, I'm using a single piece of clay for sculpting the head, or should I say torso, and tentacles of the creature. Just make sure to maintain about 2/3 of the overall clay mass into the legs, but obviously you can vary it depending on the effect you want to pursue. If you want larger animal, more menacing, you may want to have longer legs for it, so you should attach more clay pieces for the leg portion. But if you want like a tiny cutie version of an octopus, you may even decide to have half for the torso and half for the legs of the overall clay mass. So frankly speaking, it is quite hard to maintain the proportions for 8 separate limbs and make sure that their thickness and length is going to be the same, so eventually we'll have to add clay pieces for one leg and tentacle and remove them from another. So don't be afraid of that, just make sure that once you're done with the overall proportions, they are as close to each other as possible. So limbs, tentacles are going to be one of the most complicated things to do on our project. Complicated in the sense of a time consumption, because you will have to create circular protrusions on its bottom spaces, and I will show you how I managed to do that. In most cases, octopus have brighter protrusions on the lower side of their limbs, which are able to attach to its prey once it is hunting or like trying to grab something, and they are following this symmetrical pattern, and starting from the smaller one, they are increasing in size, going along all the way and attaching, like connecting to the middle of the body. And of course, once you're done with that, you will also have to create the bumps, tiny bumps and dips onto the surface of the skin of an octopus. If you have seen the camouflage effect they can produce, they can not only change the color of their skin, but the surface. They can create bumps and irregularities in order to match the surface of the nearby area, which is crazy. And finally, our octopus is done. I'm quite happy with this look. I wanted to create this kind of more simplistic look to showcase the details on its skin and not to conceal them with a fancy camouflage they can create. And it is very fascinating to watch. I would really suggest to check out real actual images and videos of octopus. That they are really fascinating creatures, and to be honest, I have just found out that they really have 2 legs and 6 limbs, as scientists call 2 hind protrusions legs, because they are using them for movement on the seafloor, and other 6 are more often used for like grabbing something, prey or some kind of random objects. And yeah, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this rather different episode of mine, other than that fantasy things I have sculpted so far, and also really hope that you will try making these amazing creatures by yourself. And yeah, we will see each other in the next week. Have a nice day and see you next time. Goodbye.